stop at a sailboat, Mari.
Stop.
Stop at a jetty.
Stop.
Stop at $4,000. And it spins.
Stop.
Stop. Stop at a whinny.
Players are after high stakes, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting games of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter DeMarkin.
Thank you. Thank you once again, Rod. And welcome to Press Your Luck. We're going to have some fun today. Right, Rod?
Absolutely.
I just want to see if Rod was awake. I was checking. I tell you, well, without further ado, let's meet the three players who are going to be pressing their luck today, starting with John Biscossi. John, how are you?
All right.
Is that the entire Biscossi family in the audience?
No, the other half's in Rome.
In Rome, ah. Now, you are an ex-Marine, correct?
Yep.
And you're involved in pizza, as we most are most Sunday nights. So how are you involved?
My family owns a couple pizzerias and a couple restaurants back in New York.
Oh, really? Manhattan?
No, upstate. Saratoga, the racetrack.
Oh, by the racetrack. Yeah. All right, make good pizza?
Great pizza.
You share some recipes with us?
Nope.
Thank you. We won't share any money with you.
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on. We'll see how you do. Good luck, John.
Thank you.
Okay, good to have you with us. Let's meet Terre Fox. How are you, Terre?
I'm great, Peter. How are you?
Where are you from, Terre?
Los Angeles.
And you are a flight attendant.
Yes, I am.
And you fly all over the country?
All over the country, primarily New York.
Uh-huh. That's nice. Now, you also like to ride a bike.
I love to ride a bike. It's because I love to eat, so that gets the weight off.
Works in.
Works one against the other. You got it.
How many miles do you bike?
40 to 50 miles each time out.
You do like to eat.
Oh, yes. I love to eat.
You look great, though. Welcome to the
Thank
show.
Thank you.
And let's talk to our returning champion, Mac McHugh.
Hi, Peter. How are you?
$9,449.
Yeah. Wow.
What a hunk of change.
Oh,
Mac,
my.
I got to ask you. I understand that you once got a promotion using popsicle sticks in the when you were in the military?
Yeah, we had a pass and review, you know, where you parade, and I'd injured my hand. And I knew if I had to go out there in front of the troops and salute, the hand was going to be like this. Right. We were lucky it was wintertime. So I took popsicle sticks and taped them to the inside of my hand and put it in the glove. And the next day, the old man said, hey, that was great. You're promoted. So I never argued either.
If there hadn't been popsicle sticks, you'd never been promoted.
I doubt it. But I never told him either, I'll tell you that
That's
much.
Great. That's well done, Mac. Want to make some more money?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it. Players, I've got four questions. Your correct answers will earn you spins of the big Press Your Luck game board. A correct buzz and answer gives you three spins. A correct multiple choice, one spin. The more spins you have, well, obviously, the more money you can win. Because that board up there has a lot of dollars on it, a lot of prizes. And every time you stop the board, like I'm going to do now, stop. Wait a minute. How much did I lose? About $8 million. Well, you see that? You want to avoid it, because if you get the whammy, he takes away all your money. And believe me, he has enough money. He does not need yours. So stay away from him. All right, are you ready to press your luck?
You bet it.
Okay, here we go. According to a surprising survey by Psychology Today magazine, what fraction of married people said they have cheated on their spouse? John.
Three quarters.
Three quarters, says John. All right, is the correct answer. Three quarters, one quarter, or one half? Terre?
I'll say one half.
Terre goes with one half. Let's go over to Mac.
I'm going to be different. One quarter.
One quarter. Well, the survey said that one half the married people admitted to cheating on their spouse. That means that Terre goes to one. The other half were lying. Okay, here we go with question two. Aside from plain water, what is America's favorite thing to drink? John?
Coca-Cola.
All right, is the correct answer Coca-Cola, milk, or coffee?
Terre? I'll say coffee.
Terre says it's coffee. Let's see what Mac has to say.
I'll say coffee.
Coffee. That popular American beverage is indeed coffee. Correct. That means that Terre goes to two, and Mac picks up a spin. Here we go with the next question. Here's a household hint. According to the Los Angeles Times, what's the only natural fabric that will not fade if you dry it in bright sunlight? Terry.
Wool.
All right, is the correct answer wool, cotton, or silk? John?
I'll go with wool.
Wool, says John. What do you think?
Mac? I'll go along with wool.
You will. Well, that color-fast fabric is cotton, gang, not wool. No, no spins. Well, okay. Here we go with the fourth question. You can be as poor as a church mouse or as old as the hills, but what biblical character can you be as patient as? Mac?
Job.
All right. Is the correct answer Job, Moses, or Methuselah? John?
Methuselah.
All right, John says it's Methuselah. Let's go to Terry.
Job.
You're as patient as Job.
Yay!
That means Terry winds up with 3. Mac has 4, sorry. John doesn't have any spins, but you'll have a chance to convert the spins you have into dollars when we come back right after this. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Guess what? We're back. And we're back with the big Monstro board up there that has prizes, surprises, over $13,000 in cash, and some monsters known as whammies. Stay away from them. The player who ends this round with the most money will play last in the final round, and that is a big advantage. Remember, you can pass your remaining spins if you're afraid of the whammy anytime during your turn, and 4 whammies put you out of the game. All right, the player with the fewest spins goes first. That's John, but there's so few you don't get to go, John, although you'll get another chance next round to get some more spins. Right now, we'll go to the next player, Terry, with 3 spins. You're going to go first, least spin. Now you're ready, Terry.
Stop
at a whammy. Still hasn't learned to skate. Terry, $0, 2 spins, 1 whammy. You want to try it again? Here we go.
Stop.
Oh. I guess that's called doing the chicken.
Yes, I guess
Terry,
it is.
Terry, 2 whammies, no dollars, 1 spin. You want to be careful about picking up a 3rd whammy for round 2, but you have 1 spin left.
I'm going to go
pleasure.
With the 1 spin.
Going to go. All right. Here we go. Big move. Stop. Here we go. All $200. Right. Terry, you avoided that whammy. $200 for it. Let's see how you hold up when we go to Mac with $0 and 4 spins. Mac, make some money.
Go. You want some big money up there. Stop.
Stop at $300. First that place, Mac. 100 more than Terry, 3 spins left.
I'm going to go.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at $1,000. Mac, you're up to $1,300. 1,100 more than Terry. You have 2 spins left. Press your luck.
One more.
Here we go. Mac's going for it.
One more. Stop.
Stop at $1,000. Again. $2,300, Mac. You have 2,100 more than Terry. You have 1 spin left. You going to take it?
You know old Santa Claus.
Santa Claus. Mac passes that spin to Terry. 1 for you, Terry. Avoid the whammy. Here we go. $200.
Stop!
Stole your stash, Terry. Mac felt it coming on. We have Terry with $0, John with $0, and Mac, you're leading with $2,300.
Yay.
You got the advantage, champ. We'll be right back. With more questions, spins, prizes, and surprises, right after this. Players, I have 4 more questions here. Hopefully, they'll produce answers. Answers produce spins. In this round, a spin can be worth as much as $5,000. And the player with the most money at the end of this round takes what they've won home today and gets to come back again tomorrow. That's important. Now, before we go, I'm not going to say before we go. I'm going to go right to the first question because I know John's going to come through on this round. Are we ready? Here we go. They used to be called love apples, but nowadays we call them by their right names and usually eat them in salads. What are they? Mac.
These small tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
They're tomatoes.
All right, tomatoes. Is the correct answer tomatoes, avocados, or capers, John?
Avocados.
Avocados. Okay, Terry, what do you think?
I'll say tomatoes.
Tomatoes. Well, love apples are now called tomatoes. Terry goes for one, and Mac picks up three. Here we go with the second question. Tomatoes go on pizzas. Even
sauce.
But you don't get a spin for that. I don't get a spin for knowing that, do I? I guess not. Okay. There may be more Visa cards in the world than any other, but more money has been charged on another old line credit, John.
Diners Club.
Credit card, what is it? All right, is it Diners Club, as John said, MasterCard, or American Express? Terry?
I'll say American Express.
Terry goes with American Express. Mac?
Being as how she's with the airline, she ought to know who she's traveling with. I'll say American Express.
American Express, a long answer, Mac. Okay, the most money has been charged on American Express. Don't leave home without it. Nothing for John yet. Terry goes to two and Mac to four. Now, I know, John, you've been hanging back.
It's coming through.
This is strategy, but you're going to come out of the bushes now, I know.
Definitely.
Okay, third question. She was recently made an honorary Boy Scout. She's Larry Hagman's mother, and she may be best known for playing...
Mary Martin.
For playing Peter Pan. Who is she? Is it Mary Martin, Helen Hayes, or Gail Storm? What do you think, John?
It's Mary Martin.
Mary Martin, says John. Let's go to Mac.
Mary Martin.
Hey, Mary Martin. That talented lady, John. Are you ready, John?
Come on, just give me one.
Is Mary Martin. Picks up a spin. There it is. Terry goes to five. Mac to five. All right. Now we're out of the bushes and running like crazy. All right. Think quick. How many hills was Rome originally built on? Terry?
Nine.
Is the correct answer nine, five, or seven? John?
I should know this.
Yep.
Nine, five, or seven, you say?
Yeah.
I'll go for seven.
You go for seven, will you, John? Okay, Mac, what do you think?
I'll back John on seven.
Seven? John, Rome was not built in a day, but it was built on seven hills.
Right.
Big John goes to two. Terry stays at five, and Mac goes to six. Well done, John. You can go back and visit your people now. All of us will be taking those spins from the big board and decide who the winner's going to be in fresh luck. So come on back, John and Terry and Matt will be here. Players, it is big bucks time. You know you can win a bundle on Press Your Luck because there's over $50,000 in cash up there just waiting for you to get your hands on it. In fact, there's one prize worth more than $5,000. Don't forget the whammy because he'll take away all your money if he gets a chance, so be very careful. Also, remember, we've got some new surprises up there on that board. In fact, one of those surprises will double your winnings. Important. Let's take a look at your dollar totals. We have John with $0. We have Terry with $0. And we have Big Mac. Big Mac, that's clever on my part, isn't it?
Yeah, it certainly is.
$2,300. Mac, you're in first place, which means you play last. Sit back, have a Big Mac. We're going to go to the player with the least number of spins. That player is Big John. All right, John.
All right.
$0, two spins. Let's go. Press your luck.
Going to get a spin. Stop.
Stop at $1,750. Okay. John. $1,750, second place, one spin left. You got about $550 more to catch up to Mac.
I'm gonna go.
John's going.
Looking for
big bucks. $1,500. $3,250, John. You acquitted yourself well. First place for now. We now go to Terry. Now, Terry, you have three whammies. You have five spins and no dollars, but those three whammies are what you have to watch out for. One more, and you're out of the game, okay? $1,500. Third place, Terry, $800 less than Mac. Gonna go again. Terry's pulling out all the stops here.
Stop!
Stop at all.
I can't turn around. You lose.
Terry, I'm sorry. You're out of the game. We go to Mac, our champ, $2,300. Mac, you're against John. Six spins. Are you ready?
You better believe it.
Here we go.
Come on, big bucks. Big bucks. Stop.
$4,000 and a spin. You're up to $6,300, Mac, and you still have six spins. You've got $3,000 more than John.
I gotta go.
Here we go.
Gotta go. Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $1,400. $7,700. Five spins left. Press your luck or pass.
Gotta go.
Here we go.
Gotta go. Stop.
$1,250 for you, Mac. That's about $6,700 more than John. You have four spins left.
And I'm going.
Going. Mac says he's going.
Stop.
Stop at $700 and a spin. You're now up to $9,650 and four spins. What's your pleasure, Mac? You've got $6,400.
Gotta go.
He's
gotta
there.
Go.
Here we
come
go.
Come on, big butt.
$9,650 at stake.
Stop.
Stop at $2,000. There's those five figures, Mac. $11,650. $8,400 more than John. Three spins left. $8,400. What you gonna do, Mac?
One more time.
One more step back. $11,650 at stake.
Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at Denver.
Hey, I'll take
a trip to Denver with a value of $1,720. You're up to $13,370. That's $10,120 more than John. Two spins.
Santa Claus again.
Santa
Hello,
Claus
John.
Is back. John, you thought you were out of it. You are not out of it. You have two spins bequeathed to you by Mac. $3,250. You've got some catching up to do. You have to take them one at a time. Here they go, John.
All right.
Looking for big bucks.
Come on, big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $1,000 and a spin. All right, John, you move the spin that you earned over in the earned column. And you have $4,250. Still some catching up to do, $9,000, but you still have two spins. One you have to take, and here it comes.
Stop.
Stop at $4,000 and a spin. John, you're up to $8,250, and you have two spins. So you're still back where you were. Same two spins. You've got $5,100 to catch up. You can pass him to Mac. What are you gonna do, John?
Go!
Go!
Watch out,
here you go! $8,250.
Stop!
Stop at a portable spa! John, that portable spa has a value of $2,995. You are now at $11,245. That is $2,125 less than Mac. You can either take that last spin. If you get more money than that $1,125, you'll be the new champion, or you can pass it to Mac. If he whammies, you're the champ. What's your pleasure?
When I can't do an answers, Peter, I'm going to do in a roll. Let's
John's
go.
John's going to go for himself. This is it. $11,245. Who's the champ? John or Mac? $2,000! $2,000 is 13,245 is Mac. The champion with $13,370. Congratulations, Mac. We'll be right back to find out exactly what you won right after this. Thank you, and we are back with today's big Press Your Luck winner, Mac, with $13,370. And Mac, the one, the only, the illustrious one, Rod Roddy, is going to tell you exactly what you won, Rod.
I certainly will, Peter. Mac, listen to this. You won a trip to Denver, a round trip, flying holidays for two, air coach from Los Angeles to Denver, Colorado. Aboard Western Airlines, enjoy warm hospitality and delicious cuisine from Western in Denver. You and your companion will enjoy a five-night stay, modified American plan, at the new Viscount Hotel, conveniently located near many attractions, including the Denver Mint, a major amusement park offering special services, luxury accommodations, and fine dining from Viscount Hotels. That prize totaling $1,720 combined with the $11,650 in cash you've won today and the previous $9,449 in cash and prizes you won before gives you a grand total of $22,819. Merry Christmas, Santa!
Congratulations, Mac! Well done. John, only $125 separated you from Mac. Yeah, you came out of the bushes, but a little bit short. Well done. Terry, the Whammies love pretty women. Thank you for being with us. You're not going to be going away empty-handed. We've got some nice prizes for you. Mac, we'll see you next time. Until then, we have some words of wisdom from Barry Lackman of Staten Island, New York. Unless and until the Whammy is banned, watch where you go or you could get canned. This is Peter Tamarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye.